back to Medicine Made Easy with me, Kavithan. Now we will be discussing a very important topic, and that is drug resistance in Staphylococcus aureus. The relevance of the topic is, we know Staphylococcus aureus is the most common organism that is going to cause infection, starting from skin to deeper tissues. And while treating this infection, sometimes there is no progress in the clinical course of the disease. Why? So that is what is going to be explained by this topic, that is drug resistance in Staphylococcus aureus. Before we actually go into the topic per se, if you have not subscribed to our channel, do subscribe for more interesting videos like this, and as well press the bell icon so that you will receive regular video updates. And I made this video with simple diagrams and mnemonics to remember. Hope it will be very useful to remember for later also, so you can share this to your friends and let us all learn together. The learning points from this video would be, what is the relation between Enterococcus faecalis and Staphylococcus aureus? And we'll be learning the drugs which is coming under anti-staphylococcal penicillin and drug resistance in Staphylococcus aureus. Without further delay, let us start with the anti-staphylococcal penicillin. Supposing a person is infected with Staphylococcus and he is diagnosed the same and treated with penicillins, what are the drugs we're going to give? And one thing to remember, it is going to cause skin and subcutaneous tissue infection, and it can be as serious as an osteomyelitis. Okay, so based on the severity, the drugs are given in such routes. So for serious infection, we're going to give IV and IM route. For skin and soft tissue infection, we're going to give oral, peroral routes. For Staphylococcus aureus infection, it is first preferred penicillin G. If there is methicillin sensitive Staphylococcus aureus, the drugs we're going to give is Cloxa syringes. Remember this Cloxa. So for the same MSSAM, skin and soft tissue infection, we're going to do dicloxacillin, flucloxacillin drugs. For MRSA, the drug of choice is vancomycin, that is 15 to 20 mg per kg BD. Other drug we can give is ceftobiprole, which is basically a fifth generation cephalosporin drug. And this is all parenteral. Coming to the oral, we can give linezolid, clindamycin, cotrimoxazole, doxycycline, and so on. This drug list is taken from Apurba Sastri's textbook of microbiology edition 2. Now what happens, the patient came, he has infection, Staphylococcus infection, he's treated for the same, but there's no progression of the disease. For the patient, what is the underlying reason could be, that is resistance probably. So what happens is, supposing this patient is treated with penicillin, this is one Staphylococcus aureus, this is another Staphylococcus aureus. This Staphylococcus aureus has a plasmid that codes for beta-lactamase or penicillinase. This is going to transmit this, the plasmid, to the other by transduction. By doing this, what happens? This bacteria is also producing penicillinase. This penicillinase is going to completely destroy the penicillin so that the action of penicillin is hampered. There's other condition where there is an hyperproduction of this beta-lactamase or penicillinase that in turn causes called BORSA. What is this BORSA? BORSA means borderline oxacillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus. And next, how to tackle this? We are going to give beta-lactamase inhibitor. They are basically clavulanic acid, tesobactam, and sulbactam. To remember it very easily, remember a mnemonic like, there's someone called Ampi. Ampi is saying, that is, Ampi says, PT period is so cool as an AC. So Ampi means ampicillin with sulbactam, piperacillin with tesobactam, and amoxicillin with clavulanic acid. We are more familiar with the name amoxiclav, and that is amoxicillin with clavulanic acid. Remember, amoxicillin with clavulanic acid is a tablet, so it's peroral route, the rest are parenteral route. Ampi, the word is coming first, so 1 gram. Piperacillin, no, it is second word, so 2 gram. Remember this way, so it makes more easy. There are grams. Ampi stays, so ampicillin, sulbactam. Sulbactam is 1 gram, half the times, so 0.5. Next here, 2 gram. Half the times of this, no? So it is like 1 gram, 2 gram, multiply by 2, 0.5 gram, 0.25 gram, so divided by 2. So tesobactam is 0.25 gram. Next, coming to amoxicillin, we know amoxicillin is 500 milligram or 250 milligram, and clavulanic acid is 125 milligram. This is a fixed drug combination. And one of the other types where there is a resistance by is, there can be expression of MEK gene and MEK C gene. By this expression, what happens is the penicillin binding protein is altered, and because of that alteration, the affinity to the beta-lactam antibiotics are decreased. Then as a result of that, the infection persists. So MEK-A, MEK-C gene. Next, coming to our important discussion. That is, see, supposing that's an infection, we are giving him vancomycin. Now, what happens? This bacteria can show one change, that is, there is thickening in the cell wall. By this, there is a vancomycin intermediate Staphylococcus aureus. There can be the other thing happening. See, what happens is, this is an Staphylococcus aureus. When a vancomycin resistant Enterococcus faecalis is coming in contact with that Staphylococcus aureus, there is an horizontal conjugation transfer of what? Van A gene. So this vancomycin resistant Enterococcus faecalis is going to give Van A gene by horizontal conjugation transfer, so that this Staphylococcus aureus is now going to develop that. But what happens is, this Van A gene is going to combine with the genomics of this bacteria. By combination, what happens? There is a compensatory gene mutation which is happening in this Staphylococcus aureus. This mutation is compensatory. Sometimes the bacteria can live, sometimes it cannot live. When it is surviving, it becomes a VRSA, that is vancomycin resistant Staphylococcus aureus. Majority of times, it will not survive. That means what? The fitness is decreased. And this phenomenon is called as fitness cost phenomenon. This fitness cost phenomenon is usually seen in VRSA. And majority of times, by this fitness cost phenomenon, the bacteria is decreasing in fitness, so it is not living. And the incidence of VRSA is very, very less when compared to MRSA. So now we know how does Enterococcus faecalis is related to Staphylococcus aureus in development of resistance. Now how to treat it? The drugs for that is linezolid, telavancin, and daptomycin. These are drugs. How to remember is simple. See, this is Van A gene is all happening in a more line way, line fashion, right? So linezolid and Van A gene is involved. So remember, telavancin and daptomycin. That's all. Now, after this, we are coming to one important pharmacological point, that is, beta-lactamase inhibitor, what are we going to give, are suicidal inhibitors, and they are going to act only on plasmid-mediated penicillinase. That means there are bacteria, that is Pseudomonas, Serratia, Enterobacter, that is producing penicillinase, but not through plasmid. It is producing through some chromosomes. So if at all you are going to apply this beta-lactamase inhibitor, this is not going to act on chromosome-mediated penicillinase production, that is by Pseudomonas and Serratia. This is one important point. Now coming to the summary. Now what happens in Staphylococcus aureus? There is beta-lactamase production and can be tackled with beta-lactamase inhibitor. MRSA, which is by MAC-A C gene, tackled by vancomycin generation cephalosporin. And to eliminate the carrier, that is nasal carriers of MRSA, we can be giving mupirocin. For skin carriers, we'll give chlorhexidine. Coming to VISA or VRSA, that is because of Van A gene, which is from vancomycin-resistant Enterococcus faecalis. For that, what I'm going to give the drug is linezolid. I hope I've delivered all the points clearly and you got the answers for what is the relation between Enterococcus faecalis and Staphylococcus aureus in development of resistance. And you know at least some names of anti-staphylococcal penicillin. Just remember, for MSSA, cloxacillin. And for MRSA, drug of choice is vancomycin and ceftobiprole. Next is how the drug resistance is developing in Staphylococcus aureus. Beta-lactamase, MRSA, BORSA, VSA, VRSA. So thank you so much for your patient listening. We'll all meet in the next video. Till then, stay tuned. Bye-bye.